forward all month long here on Golf Channel, we are featuring African-American-owned businesses in the game of golf. This week we go to South Florida for the story of two female entrepreneurs making a splash in the golf bag market.
So the ORCA is this beautiful, huge, powerful, misrepresented mammal. Most people feel that the ORCA is a whale. The ORCA is a dolphin. I call it the dolphin with the most beautiful paint job that you can ever find. We wanted a company that had some kind of purpose and power. And when I say power, I don't mean power for what it does, but mostly power for what it offers. We're really the only women in the United States who are owners who design and produce car bags. When we started, we thought, let's do this, you know, because it is something that we felt was necessary. We designed for the golfer, we listen to what the golfer wants, we find materials that are just a little more premium, but lightweight enough for the average golfer to carry. So I was born and raised in Jamaica in very exceedingly humble circumstances. We had no running water, we had no electricity. Golfers were some word of the word in my country. But I have to tell you, one of the reasons why Tiger Woods will forever be a larger than life person to me is because Tiger Woods brought golf to my country.
Tiger Woods is the 100th U.S. Open champion in history.
Every time we played it, everybody paid attention, everybody tuned in. That was my introduction to golf. We want ORCA Golf to represent not just, you know, quality golf fans, but thinking about the future of golf. You know, the future of golf for people who look and sound like me, and making golf a little more diverse in a tangible way. You know, it's easy to say that we want the game of golf to grow, and we want it to be more inclusive and more diverse. But what are we doing tangibly? We want the legacy of ORCA Golf to be the first company that took a simple golf to the next level. We made it more sustainable, and in doing so, we made the game of golf that much more inclusive.
Wonderful story from South Florida this year.